This episode of How to Spin Yarn has been brought to you by SpinOlution, state-of-the-art spinning wheels proudly made by families in the USA. And by My Local Wool. Find farms, festivals, artisans, and shops near you by visiting mylocalwool.com. Welcome back to Spindling and our first series in Plied called Simplified. This is just two-ply yarn, simple, but we're going to take an extra twist on it. Sarah's going to be doing a two-ply from a dark and a light bulky hand spun, and I'm going to do a two-ply from kind of a medium worsted and a yarn that I plied with threads. Let me show you. You can ply any two yarns together, and we're just going to play with it. So grab two yarns, and let's get going. I start by tying my yarn ends in a knot. And in the single series, we did everything in a clockwise direction. So now, for plied, we're going to be spinning everything in a counterclockwise direction. And I'm actually going to use my biggest spindle for this because of yardage, and I just think this spindle is a plying spindle.
I'll probably use that one too, actually.
Yeah, because that's going to get really big really fast. Mm-hmm. Okay.
So how do you start, like, do you tie it? I usually tie it, but I don't know if there's a better way.
You know how, I start with a loop? So tie your ends in a knot. Yeah. Just make a knot at the top.
I see.
And then tuck the knot of the two yarns into that loop.
Okay.
And then you go in a counterclockwise direction and kind of noose up the knot on the yarn. If you're brand new to spindling, plying is actually easier than spinning. So if there's two commercial yarns in your stash, you can just tie the ends in a knot and practice using your spindle with any two yarns that you have, commercial. A lot of my students, that's how I first teach them how to spin yarn, is I just have them ply, like, Red Heart.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Yeah, just a cheap yarn. So I'm going to show you what my ply is looking like. So half of it is just a simple single ply, and the other half is like a bumpy thread ply. And it's just twisting them together counterclockwise and wrapping them on.
This is the fun part.
Yeah.
I think.
Plying is so much easier than spinning. I think my plying class series is like half as much time as my spinning class series. Because it's like we've already made this much. And yeah.
This is probably more than I spun.
Yeah, this is the most, like, ounces that you've spun.
The spindle is so big, I have to do it, like, on the side.
Yeah. I wonder if it would make sense to, like, actually drop it. Like, I'm going to try.
Oh, maybe.
Oops, I'm going clockwise. Yeah, you can see how the two yarns twist together. Just like that. And that's making two-ply yarn. It's fun to ply two textures together. So if you purchase the whole masterclass series, you could ply, like, lashed with uncarded or locked with knotted. I mean, you could ply any two together. You could even ply plied yarns together. You could ply two coils together, braids together, feathers together. The possibilities are endless.
Yeah, look at that. That's filling right up.
Yep. I do think this bulky spindle is like plying spindle.
Yeah.
It's really not a spinning spindle.
Plying just feels more rewarding.
Yeah, it's fast. When we're done with this, I'll warp up my rigid heddle and you can weave all of your stuff.
That'd be cool.
Like back to back and do like a sampler. If that's what you want to use it for.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
If you happen to be on Instagram and you want to show and tell the yarns that you're spinning in this series, you can hashtag them with how to spin yarn. Or hashtag them with the word spindling. And we can see what you've made.
I'm excited to see that.
Mine is doesn't seem like it's balanced, but I think it's because half of the yarn that I'm plying has already been plied. So it's like yours is probably balanced. Like hold it kind of loosely. Oh, maybe it isn't. Well, I haven't set these singles either. Like, it's not draping.
Interesting.
Mine isn't draping either. But I think I would just steam them to set
weird.
Them.
Yeah.
What? Are you going counterclockwise?
Yeah. Weird.
It looks correct.
Yeah.
I think it's just kind of loose.
Weird.
Yeah. Since they're rolled into a ball, do you think it makes a difference what direction we ply them in? I didn't think so.
I don't think so.
I've always, always.
I don't think so.
Okay.
Maybe I was spinning it the wrong way. I don't know. That was bizarre.
Now it's
better.
There you go.
I must have done it backwards.
Yeah. There you go. That's what a balanced yarn looks like. So do that again and then show them, like, if you want to create a yarn that doesn't twist up upon itself, when you kind of give it slack, it'll just hang. It won't, like, on itself. That's a technical term, by the way. My yarn is not doing that because one of the yarns that I'm spinning with it has already been plied. So I'm putting too much twist into one yarn and I'm putting the right amount of twist into the other yarn and I'm just breaking all the rules. But it looks really pretty.
Oh, that's gorgeous.
Yeah.
But what would you do to fix that?
I would set it. I would steam it. Since this texture is pretty forgiving, I could even soak it and hang it under weight. Or I would just weave it as is, because by the time I wove it, like, it's not so rebellious that in between a warp thread wouldn't calm it down. But yeah. I work with alive yarns all the time. I only set probably 10% of my yarns, like, in all of the yarns I make. Almost all the yarns I sell, at yarn shops are also live. I just prefer the way they feel. And since they're usually not knit into projects that require a gauge, like sweaters or socks, it doesn't make as big of a deal. Yay. So I'll show you. This is my finished yarn. Really pretty. And I just tied the ends in a knot so that they stay together.
And here's mine.
Yeah, that's gorgeous.
Very cool.
And make sure when you take it off your spindle that you keep it under tension so that it doesn't, like, completely untwist. Excellent.
I think the knot helps with that too.
Yeah, maybe mine's kind of, it's close. Yeah. But it's not. It. But if I go too close, it twists on each other. But yeah, you can ply this again and do. If you were to ply this a second time, you would actually make a technique called chained, which is to ply twice. So experiment. Cheers.
Cheers.
Happy spindling.